Welcome to another edition of the Bobby Kremen Show. Of course, along with head coach Bobby Kremen of the Cougars of the College of Charleston, I'm Nate Ross, your host. And coach, the regular season ended with a trip to Appalachian State. We talked about that game on the last show. And then, of course, to Western Carolina. Before we talk about those games and show the highlights, just give me your impressions of the week.
I wish we had a different ending, Nate. Nate, we kind of hit the wall. We need a little psychoanalysis. After we won the regular season championship, right. We had played a lot of basketball. Senior night was on a Monday night. And Nate, I didn't foresee that we were going to hit the wall, that we were so tired. And plus, we were playing two very good basketball teams.
True.
And so we took, I gave them Tuesday off. We hit the road on Wednesday. But Nate, we didn't play College of Charleston basketball. And you got to give our opponents a lot of credit. But it just seemed like it was a twofold problem. Number one, we hit the wall, probably a case of complacency.
Right.
And secondly, we were playing against some good basketball teams. Donald Sins of Appalachian was great. And Western Carolina, they're a very good team. Both those teams will be a factor in the Southern Conference tournament.
And as we talked about before, going to Western, they were on a roll. I think they had six or seven in a row.
Yep.
In their building, in their senior night.
Yeah, tough on the road, Nate.
Yep. All right, we're going to take a look at the highlights of the Western Carolina game right now. Coach, here we go, Western Carolina.
Nate, we did not play well in early get going. I was hoping after the Appalachian State loss that we would respond a little better. Now, this guy, Willis Hall, he gave us a great effort. So many offensive rebounds like this one. He had a really, really good basketball game. But our main guys, Drew was tired, did not shoot well. And give Western Carolina a lot of credit. There you see the big guy, Gordon, just bulldozing his way to the basket over Trent Wiedemann. But give Western Carolina a lot of credit. There you see Antoine Wiggins. He had, Donovan, Antoine, Drew, they just had tough shooting nights. Great pass by Donovan. Nate, look at it. Every time he touched the ball, he had two men over him, but there was a great pass to the open man. Western Carolina is physical.
Big up front.
Yes. Nice move by Drew there using the backboard. I love when he uses the backboard. Now you see Netta drive. That's what I love. I love when he draws people to him and makes the open pass.
There's Williams on the steal.
College of Charleston turnover leads to an easy Western Carolina layup. We struggled, Nate. It was that simple. At halftime, I was definitely concerned. But I was very much relieved as coming into the second half that we were going to fight back. We actually cut it to 4 points. AC Drew, again, you always see shirts around him. Nice shot by Willis Hall. Every time he touches the ball, he's going to be surrounded, and that's going to happen to him. The bad defense by Kyle DeCharleston, open shot. They get the loose ball rebound.
And that's Mutombo. That's what he does.
Mutombo is always, I call him a slasher.
Yep.
They're good, Nate. Appalachian, Donald Sims put on a show against us. You saw that in last week's highlights. And now, Antoine, we're just not shooting well.
Here's second half.
And Willis Hall just saves us. Nate, we fight back second half. Donovan and Monroe in a great anticipation. Now, Nate, we were down 12 at halftime. It's about a six-point game now. We're trying to get something good. Nice pass here. And I feel like we're getting closer and closer. But we just can't get over the hump. Now, that doesn't happen very often.
Well, you see many teams where you fight like crazy to get back in the game. You just don't have enough juice to go over the top.
Yeah, and you don't see Drew shoot like
air
that.
Air balls, right.
Yes. And there's the Drew Godlock we know and love. And we get close, Nate, but you've got to give Larry Hunter and Western Carolina, you alluded to early, they had lost their first home game all year after having a 21-point lead against the Citadel on Thursday night. And this was senior night for them. I love when he does that. I love when he drives and pulls up. And, Nate, right now we're in the game. We have a chance. They see missed shot. Trent Wiedemann all over the boards. Great rebound into Willis Hall. I can't say enough. The effort was there the second half. But, Nate, again, we just hit a wall. And we just couldn't get back that Kyle DeCharleston, that great demeanor we have. Again, Drew, missing shots. Willis Hall all over the boards. Amazing.
10 offensive boards.
10 offensive rebounds. That's amazing. But again, give credit where it's due. That big guy, Gordon, he's a load. And they're a good team, Nate. They crashed the boards. Larry Hunter has turned their season around. They were struggling at midseason. And they went to a different type lineup. And they're playing some basketball. And they see Mike Williams, who's an outstanding guard. He is a scoring machine. Nate, they're good players in this league. And again, Western Carolina, they deserve this victory. They did a great job. Tough loss for us, but again, Nate, you know, we just felt, I just was mad at myself that I did not see some of this coming on. I don't know what I would have done. I would try to pull some rabbits out of the box, maybe, you know, read a Sigmund Freud book, but I'm not sure, you know, what the answer was, but there was definitely a bit of burnout for the College of Charleston Cougars.
Well, because of that, Coach, and you realize it, you gave him a couple days off as we get ready for tournament play here.
Well, Nate, you know, what I told him after the game was, you know, the regular season's over.
Right.
And, you know, I got to look at the whole body of work.
Sure.
And when you look at our whole body of work, we had an A season. And, of course, winning the regular season championship and getting an NIT bid is no easy task.
And only four losses.
And only four losses. So I can't say enough about the body of work by the Cougars. Now, that's over with. Now we have a new season. And we have a new tournament, and there's a bigger prize in this tournament. We leave for Chattanooga. We're in Chattanooga now, as you're watching this show. We did not have to play the first date, thank God.
That's big.
We got a bye, and now we'll play the winner of Citadel and
Elon,
which will be a tough game. Everybody's going to have a tough game in this tournament, and we'll go forward. But the biggest thing, Nate, is we got to get out of our little burnout, and we got to play College of Charleston basketball.
And speaking of that, and you talked about it all year, and your team accomplished the goal getting that bye. In the South Division, you and Wofford get the bye, do not have to play four games in 4 days. And in the North Division,
yeah,
Western Carolina and Chattanooga get the bye.
Everybody's going to have a tough game, Nate.
Oh, yeah.
Obviously, you know, when you get a bye, what that means is that should you win the championship, you only have to play three games. And never in the history of our SoCon tournament has a team had a win four games. We came close 1 year, but it's never been accomplished. So that's why the bye is so important.
And we're going to talk about your preparation for the tournament and resting and not resting and letting the kids show, see the games and not letting them see the games. We'll talk about all that. But first, we're going to look at the AT&T Play of the Week. And from Western Carolina, it can only be one person. Willis Hall had a tremendous game, and he is a big part of this week's AT&T Play of the Week. Our AT&T Play of the Week this week is a phenomenal effort from a phenomenal player, Willis Hall. You can see the first missed shot, and then Willis gets it in a tough spot, kicks it out for what he thinks is going to be an automatic three by Goudlock. It isn't, but he continues to make the effort. Offensive rebounding is about stick-to-itiveness. Willis Hall fights for possession, doesn't get the first one, and you can see Antoine Wiggins throws him a ball in a tough spot. He finds his teammate and doesn't believe the shot's going in, as all great rebounders don't. He goes and gets it and tips it back in. 21 points, 18 rebounds, 10 offensive boards. Willis Hall, our AT&T Play of the Week and our AT&T Player of the Game.
And now the purple dusk of twilight time steals across the meadows of my heart.
Once upon a time, there were three bears who lived together in a house of their own in a wood.
Until Goldilocks sat in the chair.
In the network, no matter where you are, you're never far. AT&T, rethink possible.
Welcome back to the Bobby Kremen Show once again. And this week on Cougar Conversations, we have Jeremy Simmons, a senior from Lithonia, Georgia, with us. And we are at this special place for a very special reason. You can see the backdrop. This is where the players sit after a great game. And I'm very privileged to be here because I've never had a great game for the College of Charleston. This man's had 1,000 of them for the College of Charleston. Everybody's asking me, Jeremy, so I got to ask you. How do you feel?
I'm feeling pretty good right now. You know, last month, it's been pretty tough. You know, just sitting out, not being able to do anything. But for the most part, I'm feeling good. Just trying to live life as I can do it. So, you know, just having a good time right now watching the team. They're doing a real good job playing, and, you know, I'm having a lot of fun watching.
Well, that's good. And most importantly, and I've talked to Coach Kremins and the trainer Chris Horschel and the doctors, when all this medical stuff is done, you're going to be fine. And you can play basketball for the next 15, hopefully more than that, years, whether it be in this country, whether it be in Europe or whatever. So that's a good thing, and that's got to take a lot of stress off your mind, off your family's mind, and everything else.
Yeah, that's a great thing to know. You know, I never, you know, dealt with an injury like this. You know, I didn't really know how serious it was until the doctors explained it to me.
Right.
But, you know, just happy that after this surgery, you know, when we have it, you know, everything goes back to normal. You know, it's just recovery and rehab for a while, but they said it won't be that tough. So, you know, I'm just looking forward to getting better, that's all.
I'm sure, and you will be. All right, let's go back a little bit. At Maryland, at North Carolina, at Tennessee, some great basketball games for this basketball team. What are your memories of those games against the big boys this year?
Just going out there and playing against those real big crowds. You know, those crowds are crazy. You know, North Carolina was crazy, Maryland was crazy, Tennessee. And the good thing about the Tennessee games, we got the win on the road against a very good team.
Absolutely.
With a great coach. And, you know, just having that experience, just playing against teams like that, it does good for the school, and it does good for the players to know that we can play against anybody on any level.
And Antoine brought up a great point when we talked to him about it. How important was it for you to kind of get that one for Tony White? Because he didn't get it the last time, and that's his hometown crowd. Of course, it was Antoine's as well.
I'm sure he was smiling wherever he was watching.
Well, that's good.
But, yeah, that was a good win, you know. Just getting it for him because he was from Knoxville, and we almost got it last year, but kind of had a letdown in the second half. But, you know, being able to get it this year was real good.
You came in here with Antoine, with Drew, with Donovan and yourself. Of course, Antoine got hurt last year and isn't part of this class. But how special was it for you four guys to go through this whole transition with Coach Kremins and obviously have phenomenal success for 4 years?
It was great, you know. We learned a lot about each other. And I look at those guys like my brothers, you know. Definitely like family, you know. I'm around them, you know, almost 24 hours
sure.
a day. And, you know, we definitely learned a lot about each other. So, you know, it was a real great experience for all four of us. And, you know, it's bad that Antoine, you know, got hurt last
right.
year. But, you know, it did him some good. It gave him an extra year to keep playing. So, you know, I'm going to come back, hopefully, and be able to see him play as well. So I think it's good.
How much did Antoine, Coach Kremins, your teammates, help you deal with this? Because Coach Kremins talks about over and over and over how great you've been dealing with this situation.
They kept winning.
That's the biggest.
But, you know, they've been supportive. You know, they treat me like I'm still a part of the team. And that's real big for me. And, you know, me just having a positive attitude about it, you know, knowing that after everything's over, everything goes back to normal. And, you know, there's still a rare hope that I could come back, but, you know, we're not looking forward to it too much. But, you know, I'm still looking into it. But just the fact that they keep supporting me and everything is real good.
And the winning is the most important thing. Speaking of winning, without you in this beginning of the season and mostly the season, this team is not in the position they're in. You have a bye in the Southern Conference tournament. You had a phenomenal season, only 4 losses in the conference. It's got to be satisfaction to you to know you were a huge part of that.
Yeah, it's great. And, you know, I definitely like the job that, you know, Trent and James came and did, you know, the last couple of games. You know, Trent's been playing, you know, phenomenal to me. You know, it's almost like I'm not even there anymore.
Trust me, they wish you well.
No, but he's doing great. And, you know, it's just good to be a part of this team, you know, the way they're playing right now, you know, whether I'm playing or not. And, you know, I wish they had great success in the tournament. You know, we're looking to get to the NCAA.
Of course. This man has been a part of this basketball team, obviously, for 4 years. The beginning of this year, the middle of this year, as you just heard from him, he's been part of this basketball team the rest of this season. We want to thank Jeremy for being with us on Cougar Conversations, which is brought to you by, of course, our great friends at Coca-Cola. And we'll be back with more of the Bobby Kremins Show right after these words. Welcome back to the Bobby Kremen Show. And, Coach, we talked about Western Carolina. As you said, it's over. Regular season's over. Now it's tournament time. How do you get your team back to the goal, to where you want to be, so come tournament time? You got a couple days to get ready.
Well, first and foremost, you got to establish your goal. And our goal is to, reestablish ourselves, get it back. That's our goal. And Nate, we talked about rest, burnout. You have to get a little rest, right, but then you got to get after it. And so the game plan is to, get it back somehow, some way. Obviously, if I had the answer to that, I would put it in a jar and sell it for millions. There's no direct answer. You got to go by instinct and by feel. I trust our players. I'm very proud of our players, and therefore, we won't panic, but we will sit down and we'll talk about it, and then we'll get on the court. And we'll go work very, very hard.
Now, because of the advantage you have in that you have a bye, you get to sit and watch. You don't know who you're going to play between Elon and the Citadel. How do you balance between and set priorities between more concern about what you guys do or what the other team does, because you don't know who you're going to play until you get there?
Definitely more about us. It's always about us. We have to respect our opponent.
Sure.
I let my assistants do the scout. Regardless of who we play, and, we have nothing to do with that. That'll be a tough game because Elon and Citadel are both very good teams. And we'll just play the winner of that game. And again, it's going to be about us reestablishing ourselves and playing the type of basketball that we've been playing, going down the stretch of the season.
Different styles in Elon and Citadel. Elon, more of the Davidson style, obviously, yep, because of Matt Matheny's association with Davidson.
Yep.
Citadel's got the great shooters.
That's right.
Like you said, it's about you, but any one you'd rather play than the other?
Not really. Both have had some great wins. Citadel was really hot in midseason, then they cooled off, and then, wow, 21 points down at Western to come back and beat Western, of course, Cameron Wells. And then you talked about Elon, and they're like another Davidson team. Yep. Great ball movement.
Big guys shoot the threes.
They're good, Nate.
Oh, yeah.
Elon is good. So, for us, we know we're going to have a first tough round opponent. The winner of our game will probably get to face Chattanooga, and Chattanooga, of course, will be playing on their home court.
Sure.
Of course, the other bracket, wow, you got some great games in the other bracket, Wofford. Nate, if you ask me, who's the hottest team going into the tournament right now, I got to say Wofford. Why? They went up to Chattanooga and beat them handily.
Yes.
And then last game of the year, they went over to Furman. Furman had previously beaten them at Wofford.
True.
And they defeated Furman pretty easily. And Furman's one of the hottest teams in the league. So going in, Nate, I would say Wofford's the hottest team going into the tournament right now. And Mike Young, that's where you want to be.
Sure.
And that's where we got to find ourselves.
Well, and as you say, people watching this now, the tournament is about to begin on Saturday. Will you let your guys go watch the game to see who they're going to play, or you sit in the hotel? It's a tough call sometimes.
No, we'll practice. Chattanooga has a practice facility.
Right.
I doubt if we'll go over to the games. My assistants will go over and scout. But I think we'll practice and then go back to the hotel. We play late Saturday night. We play at 9:30. And let me explain the reason for that. Whoever the host team is, because of ticket sales, they get a little advantage.
Right.
Because we want a lot of people from Chattanooga to buy tickets and come to the games. So they try and schedule it so that they can get as many fans as possible. And that's very understandable. I completely understand why they do that.
Well, you're stealing my script here. I was just going to ask you, since you play late at night, and you've been through it in the ACC battles and all that because of television and because of the ticket situation at Chattanooga, which is true. Tough day, long day.
You don't want to make too much out of it. It is a long day. You wake up a little bit later. You have to shoot around at the practice gym.
Right.
And, it is what it is. Personally, I don't care if we play at 9:30 in the morning or 9:30 at night. We just got to reestablish ourselves and get back to playing College of Charleston basketball.
And we're going to take a quick look around the NCAA, brought to you by our great friends at Piggly Wiggly. We've talked about this before. Big East, 16 teams, They're talking maybe 11 teams in the NCAA tournament.
Absolutely amazing. Amazing. If 11 teams from the Big East go to the Big Dance, that would be absolutely incredible. Be hard for me to believe. Yep. But no question. Now, you know I bleed ACC and Southern Conference basketball. All right, Big East, I surrender. You have the best league.
This year.
This year. Only this year. The ACC will be back.
What about Steve Lavin and St. John's?
Coach of the Year. You know, when you look at National Coach of the Year, my vote is for Steve Lavin. You got the BYU coach.
Sure.
You got San Diego State, Steve Fisher.
Yep.
You got some other coaches doing a great job. But, you know, being a New Yorker, I haven't watched New York basketball. And, of course, bringing his former mentor, Gene Cady, back with him. My National Coach of the Year goes to Steve Lavin at St. John's.
And how about Mr. Greenberg up at Virginia Tech beats the number one team, the Duke Blue Devils?
Seth is always on the bubble. And what a great win for him to get that big, big home win against the number one Duke. I agree with Dick Vitale. The Hokies are in the Big Dance.
And they took game day there, and it paid off as Virginia Tech beat Duke. To knock off the number one team. That's been happening all year. Number one team just gets beat. We're going to come back. We're going to finish up the Bobby Kremen Show right after these messages. Stay with us. Welcome back once again to the Bobby Kremen Show as we close out this week's segment. We just want to get you up to speed as what's going to happen in the Southern Conference Tournament. As Coach Kremen's alluded to, the Cougars have a bye in the tournament. So they will play Saturday evening in the scheduled 9:30 game. And because of the bye, they have to see who wins between Elon and the Citadel, and that will be their first round opponent. Should they win that game, they'll be in the semifinals, and that will be on Sunday night around the same time. You can watch those games on Sports South and on ESPN3, and should the Cougars prevail there, they'll be on ESPN2 for the finals of the Southern Conference Tournament on Monday. This is not the last show because the Cougars are in postseason play. They have an NIT in their back pocket and a bid to that tournament, and hopefully they will get an NCAA bid by winning the Southern Conference Tournament. So for everybody that puts the show together, and for Coach Kremen and myself, we want to thank you for watching. And we hope you'll join us next week once again on the Bobby Kremen Show.